Yeah. There's something over here that I recognise that I really fancy. This.
Yeah.
For sale?
It's for sale.
What would you like?
What do you reckon it's worth?
As little as I can get away with.
What's as little as you can get away with?
Well, strangely, I bought two of them before.
Right.
Pretty much exactly the same. I bought one of them about 8 years ago, and it was one of the most fun finds I've ever had, and absolutely loved it, and massively regretted selling it. I have to buy it. OK, there's no way round this.
This hand-painted sign would have been used to draw customers to one of the fairground's most popular attractions, the Dodgem cars. In the recognisable psychedelic style of mid-century British showman art and signed by the painter, it could be worth around £1,500.
Give us a figure. I've got a figure in mind, but you
What
can
did
tell.
You pay for the last one?
£400.
You sure? A monkey buys it.
Done. Oh, yes, brilliant. Excellent. I never thought I'd get one of those again. I'm made up with that. So, Gary said a monkey will buy it. So, a monkey's buying it with a monkey. I'm having that. £500, I'm having it.
The unframed picture of a little girl is oil on canvas. Signed A. Weston and dated 1949, it could be worth around £300.
The young girl painting. What can I say? I'm glad she's not my daughter. Terrifying. What, you know, that child looks like. It's like, just strangled the puppy. You know, it's got that sort of menacing look about it, and it's also very well put together. It's a very nice composition.
To make the most of the bargain, Drew's going for a joint deal on the painting together with the small brass vet's plaque.
And you said £80 for the little surgeon thing.
For this?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Nicely done. Would have been on a big box where, you know, he probably carried it around, you know, cows in labour, all that James Herriot stuff. But it's a 19th century one, and looking at it, I think it's an early 19th century one as well. So a nice piece, a fun piece. Can we do £350 the pair?
Okay.
Yeah. Sold. No. Wonderful. Thank She's you. So menacing.
We bought a car showroom decades ago, and it had been closed for years, and we found it up in the attic. I kept it because she's so cute.
Shame it's got the blue paint on it, isn't it? John Bull. Yeah, it's original.
The tyres don't interest me, but she is. The look on her face, she's just lovely, isn't she?
Printed on cardboard, time has been kind to this advertising poster from the interwar years of the 1930s. With a lot of reproduced motoring memorabilia on the market, genuine originals like this are highly sought after by automotive collectors. This could be worth around £250.
It would have cost pence to make, but now it's extremely enigmatic. The expression's good, the colour is still very vibrant. Has one problem, it's got some blue paint across the top of it, which is sort of really does knock it. It really does that. Apart from that, it's just a lovely piece. Do you want to sell it?
You suggest a figure.
I think without the blue paint, I'd be like £150.
Mm, but with?
Half.
I would think 100.
Yeah.
OK. OK.
Thank you.
Good deal with you. All right, yeah, yeah. It's just a really happy piece of motoring history. That came in that frame. The way it's been manufactured, it's actually part of it and it's in it. And you can see when you look at the back, all the fixings are correct. It's exactly right for the period. I don't know, it makes you smile, you know?
My father collected anything military, vintage, cars, but his biggest passion was steam trains.
He was a railway enthusiast.
Yeah, enthusiast.
Not a train spotter.
Yeah. We like that noted. Sadly, in April, my father died, so all of this has been left to my sister, me and my brother. So it'd be nice to see a lot of the things go and sent to new homes and hopefully be restored to the beauty they should be.
Drew's being allowed in before anything actually goes to auction. A great opportunity for him to get in on the action ahead of the general public.
Drew,
nice
how are
you? Nice to meet you. Nadine.
Vicky,
hi.
Hello.
Hi, MT.
Hello.
How are you doing? So how long's it taken to amass this lot, then?
About 40.
40 years. First impressions are good. There's more things here than I thought. And this, it's just a little gold mine, this place. It really is, potentially. The things I'd be interested in here would be the obvious ones, which are the shell sign, and the Blackstone oil engine sign. Be interested in that as well.
We've had a lot of interest in that one.
What's your top bid that you've had on that so far?
Well, I was told it was worth about 2,000 quid, that Blackstone quid. Oils, because...
It's a real early one.
Yeah, it is.
It's for steam engine oil.
Yeah, you don't need that
immaculate one, he paid 4,000 for it.
God. What value do you have on the motor oil, Shell motor oil sign? Hanging sign.
Well, you'd have to make us an offer.
Right, I'm not an expert on signs. I'm just buying it for its decorative appeal.
Yeah.
There's loads of enamel signs everywhere, and a couple of real good ones. There's one over there for oil for steam engines. I've not seen one that old before. Ooh!
You don't get many of them surviving.
Oh, what?
And that was in a garage behind a set of drawers.
No way. Bino shows me this fantastic sign for BSA, for their push bikes. BSA means Birmingham Small Arms. They made rifles, and then they went into making bikes. This thing is a neon with the BSA logo in front of it, and I instantly think, ooh, I'm having that. That Again, could be the only one left. How much is it?
I've been offered good money for it already.
What have you been offered?
1,000.
1,000?
Yeah.
Or I'm not gonna try.
No, I'm just saying.
An excellent thing. A really, really good thing. Quite a find. He finds some good gear, this fella.